How's it going, YouTube? This is Mitch Santona back with a Transformers review. This is for the Deluxe Class, Revenge of the Fallen repaint, under the Generations 2010 Hunt for the Decepticons line. Here is, on the hunt for Oil Pan, which is bio-stated, I bring you Tuner Skids. Tuner Skids is a nice little repaint of this guy. And I think a slight remold. When I mean slight remold, I mean they fixed a few of the issues that this guy had. So, pretty much. Whoa! A little bit of a technical difficulty there. Getting nuts with my skids. So let me just, you know, side by side on this guy. You can see it's just mainly paint. And to be honest, I think I prefer this. I really do. I like the scheme. Although I like this black hood. I do like the black trim, like on the bottom here. I think that's kind of nice. And it's got that, jungle-looking pattern. Kind of neat. I like the back of this one much better. Although I do prefer, I think, the red lights there. And I believe I prefer those clear lights. Whereas these are, like, blackouts on the lights or something. They are clear. They're very, very dark blue, and they're clear. Kind of like that. You can barely see it. It almost looks black. It's so dark, but I don't know. So anyway, character on these guys. Let me do this. Let me get on my text back here. The twins. I gave them about a 5 in character. At first, I would have given them a 1, but they kind of grew on me a little bit. They're still not my favorites. They're okay. I watched Revenge of the Fallen lately, and it was pretty amusing. I liked them. I liked them when they were fighting with Devastator, and that was kind of cool. At first, I really hated them a lot, everything about them, but they've kind of grown on me, unfortunately. So, I'll just give them a 5. Again, not my favorites, but not the worst. The mold. Give this a 9. Now, when I say mold, I'm getting into sculpt and detail and, I guess, accuracy. This is a great concept Chevy Beat, or whatever it's supposed to be, right? That's not plugged together right. And it looks great in this mode. It really does. I think it looks nice. It looks pretty clean. Couple lines, but nothing too bad. I mean, it looks like a freaking... looks like exactly what it is in real life. And when he's in robot mode, he looks exactly like his screen counterpart. So, the cinematic skids looks just like this toy. So, it's very accurate in both modes. A lot of detail in both modes. I mean, this is what it is. You're not going to see a lot of detail because that's exactly how the car looks. But I think it really is an impressive toy, mold-wise. Paint on this guy. I give it an 8. I think I prefer it to this. I do. I like this darker green. It's kind of heavily painted, like abundantly painted. Like too much almost. It seems like it's kind of caked on, almost like a custom job, which doesn't make sense because I bought this at Target today. But it's nice. It's decent. Now he's got like a different kind of goldish color to him, similar to the Tuner Mudflap. Let me get him in the picture too. We might as well show these guys off since they're brothers, right? And I'm pretty sure everybody has Tuner Mudflap by now, right? So they both got that goldish... he's got more of a yellowy gold, and he's got like an orangey gold here, but... nah, cool. Not too bad. Alt mode on this guy, I give a 7 to it. It's accurate, but I don't like the car. So, it's kind of blah. I mean, I guess you can't be all turbocharged super sports cars or F-16 fighter jets, you know. I'm sure you have to mix your characters up a bit. I get that, you know, or else that would get old. So having a few guys that are just little, I don't know what these things are, eco-friendly electric cars or whatever the heck this is, that's cool. And like I said, it's not my favorite, but it's passable. It's a 7, and it's accurate to what, you know, what it looks like. So transformation, now that is where it gets a little hairy for me. So I'll do it off screen and come right back. Yeah, I figured I'd sneak a little shot in with all of them in their alt modes together. Okay, so I got him transformed, and I give his transformation a big fat 5. And the reason I give him kind of a 5 is because Well, I talked about this in some of my other reviews before, and again, it's one of those things where I don't have a lot of time on my hands. I mean, I get to do this. This is what I do for fun, and it seems a little bit lame, but you know what? The time I do have, I got to make the most of it. So when I got to sit here and fiddle and mess and futz and jack around with this guy for like 15 to 20 minutes to get him into robot mode, yeah, that's bad. I just don't have the patience for it. Now, if you like that kind of thing, then you'll like Skids or Mudflap for that matter, if you don't already own them. And I recommend it because it's very, let's put it this way, the engineering is genius. I don't discredit that at all. I think it really is a credit to the engineers who made this toy, but it's not for me. I can't. A 5 minute transformation, yay. A 25 minute transformation, no. And I haven't transformed them in a while, so I'm sure I'll be able to mess around with them and get them back a lot quicker. But a lot of fiddly bits on Skids and Mudflap, especially. Actually, I think I have more problems with Skids. However, they have corrected in robot mode, which is my next category, which I give a 7 to. They have corrected some of the flaws in the original toys, which is the thing, the little hook in the back, that wooden hook on his backpack when you folded him up. And it seems like this is just seems neater for some reason. That might be a figment of my imagination, or maybe just because the old backpack never plugged in right. And a lot of the old panels that were popping off from before, they seem pretty tight right now. This guy seems rock solid. Once you get him transformed and pegged in right, he's got his stupid move that he does. He's pretty rock solid. But robot mode, I give a 7 to. He's true to his film adaptation. He's got a lot of nice sculpt in robot mode, a lot of detail everywhere, and you can still make out what kind of a vehicle he is, so that's nice. And let's get him with his brother here. They're twins. Tuner Mudflap and Tuner Skids together. And they look like a nice combination of. They look pretty decent together, I think. Offset one another. I have a feeling that there's a big reservation on about 5 acres of land, or maybe more, of landfill, I should say, right next to all the Atari ET games, for all the Tuner Mudflaps, because that's the only thing I can find on my shelf in any store. I think every store has Tuner Mudflaps. I think you could go to a restaurant and get a Tuner Mudflap. They're just everywhere. So, off topic a little bit, but yeah, that's it. So robot mode, I give a 7. Articulation, I give about a 7 too. He's very articulate. He can do some good stuff. He's got the swivels and the ball joints. He's so panely, like you can't. He's got collision issues. Those issues where you can put his arms back a certain way and then they start to collide with other things. I mean, I guess you could fiddle it out of the way to get him to where you need it to be. Maybe the 7 is a little bit of a discredit. Because he's got ball joints and such, but my gosh, he looks dumb. Sorry. I'm not a real huge Skids fan, so sorry to call him dumb, but yeah, I mean, I don't know how well he'll stand because he is sort of back heavy. You know, he's got the kibble on the back, so that's 7 or 8. Let's call it that. And we'll move on to my quality control. I'll give it about a 7 as well. This guy's paint. And they cleaned up the quality control in the back, like I was saying. You know, everything pegs in together really well, and I like that about it. But maybe that was an engineering thing, more so than a quality control. Oh yeah, let me show this gimmick off while I'm chit-chatting too. He can punch you with the big hand. That's awesome. The paint seems very abundant. Like there's quite a bit of it, like almost too thick. And you really can't tell on camera, but man, that black looks really heavy, and the green looks really heavy too. It's like they took the old skids and just started glopping on it, and it kind of, I don't know, it kind of looks sloppy in a way. It doesn't on camera. It looks pretty neat, but up close, it seems a bit untidy, I guess, if you will. So that's, I give it a 7 for that. But it's a nice color, and I think I like this color better than the other, but I talked about that earlier. So rating overall on this figure, I give it a 6. I'm not really crazy about the twins. They're okay. They're true to the movie line. They're very true to their cinematic selves. So that's a bonus. So if you're looking for movie accuracy, these two guys are really spot on. You know, besides the tuner decos. They are decent in that regard, but they're movie toys, and if you don't like the movie aesthetic, then you might not like these guys. You know, a lot of asymmetrical stuff, a lot of weird-looking faces, and very detail-oriented transformations. Might not be for everybody. I give it a 6. I'm not a real big fan of these characters. I'm not a real big fan of the transformations. I think they have good robot modes. I think they have good alt modes. But getting from one to another is kind of a pain. So that's my rating for Tuner Skids. Keep watching, everybody, and I will be back very shortly.